This is a historical overview of the history of disability. Some of the content is quite bleak. We have a long history of institutionalization in Ireland, which will become clearer as the presentation progresses. Throughout history, disability has been treated unfavorably in comparison to their able-bodied counterparts, and subjected to some inhumane treatments, for example, killed or abandoned in the woods in ancient Greece, experienced acts of infanticide, or infant homicide, during the Renaissance, burned or drowned during the Spanish Inquisition, categorized as the helpless poor group during the reign of Queen Elizabeth in 1601, to name but a few. Othering is a term first used by Bauman in the later part of the 20th century. It could be argued that it is a form of exclusion and creates an us and them mentality. Disability has often been seen as an umbrella term without taking into account the different types of impairment or making adequate distinctions between disabilities. This led them being viewed as a homogeneous group. Religion viewed disability as an act of God, usually a divine punishment for sin, which created stigma for not only the individual but their whole family. Disabled people were recipients of charity and care and hidden away from society. They were viewed as unlovable and undesirable. The lives of disabled people in the ancient times were completely devalued, and in most cases they were put to death by the Greeks and Romans. Life expectancy was low and disease was rife. Some people with disabilities, such as achondroplasia, were kept as court jesters by a monarch or nobleman, and were employed to entertain guests. In the New Testament, Jesus was seen to cure different ailments, and it could be argued that this was the beginning of the medical model. It is said that Jesus rejected the idea that disability was as a result of sin, and people with disabilities were now included within the community. A mixed message was sent because on the one hand disability was viewed as a positive, i.e. Jesus's wounds on the cross, and on the other hand, it was viewed negatively, e.g. if you do not carefully follow his commands, the Lord will afflict you with madness, blindness, and confusion of mind, Deuteronomy 28:15. In the Middle Ages, the focus of disability moves from a religious emphasis and is viewed as a supernatural phenomena, but disability is poorly documented in this era. The eugenics movement began in the early 20th century and was a move to improve humanity by encouraging the healthiest and ablest people to have more children. One of the leading philosophers in this school of thought was Francis Galton. In this era, disabled people were more accepted, and as poverty increased, they were viewed as just another group of people trying to earn money without being stigmatized. In the pre-industrialist times, disability was viewed as productive and they contributed to the survival to the family. They were more accepted in society and lived alongside their families and communities. Some disabled people could not live at home due to various circumstances such as behavior and being perceived as monsters, and brought shame to their families. Monasteries or abbeys first began taking people in for care whilst they were ill until they recovered. This led to the establishment of hospitals, which provided more long-term care. Institutionalization became prevalent, particularly in the area of mental illness. Britain's first hospital for mental illness opened in 1337 and was called Bethlehem Hospital. It later became known as Bedlam due to the quality of care and abuse. People with disabilities were also in these institutions, as is evident from the documentary The History of the Madhouse. People emerged from these asylums with lasting psychological damage and inadequate supports to reintegrate into societies. In the 13th to 17th century, there was a shift in attitude. Begging was banned, which disproportionately affected disabled people as it was their only income. Medicine, doctors, and scientists replaced the church and the family. There was a change in attitudes regarding the poor with new laws such as the English Poor Law 1601 coming into effect. Institutions were developed and became widely used to segregate disabled people from society. Within these institutions, they were trained and made valuable through the skills they were taught. The separation of the disabled from society led to the creation of myths and mysteries surrounding disabled people, and because they were seen as abnormal, they were viewed as objects of pity. The Middle Ages marked the beginning of the professionalist care we see today, although at the time it was considered fundamentally flawed. The Age of Enlightenment was an intellectual and philosophical age of new ideas in Europe during the 17th and 18th centuries. Its aim was to crush superstition, slavery, and intolerance and to make people freer, richer and more civilized. It presented a challenge to the traditional religious views and in relation to disability, it meant more institutions were established and disability was associated with poverty and inability to work. In the post-industrialization era, Ireland had the highest rate of institutionalization in the world. Typically they were placed behind high walls, down long driveways and on the edge of communities. Disability was viewed as a personal tragedy. Humanity has been constructed in a paradigm of normal versus abnormal, which places us in boxes in which some of us fit neatly, and others badly. This ultimately led to isolation, abuse, and loneliness. The focus has largely been on rehabilitating people with disabilities in an attempt to ameliorate the effects of their disability. The workhouses under the new poor law housed, clothed, and fed the inmates in return for several hours of labor. The mining industry led to many workers becoming disabled as a result of acquired diseases and injuries associated with their work, that meant many experienced some degree of impairment. They began to investigate the differences between intellectual disability and mental illness. In the 18th to 19th centuries, there were changes in belief systems which meant that people could influence the natural order. It was not associated with religion. This led to better treatments for the disabled communities but also led to an increase to institutionalization. During the 19th century, there was an increase in schools for the deaf and blind. Braille was invented by Louis Braille 1829. The raised dot alphabet allowed blind people to have tactile access to written culture. Disabled people were often displayed in freak shows for general entertainment and were sold as such. An example of this is the Elephant Man. During the 19th to 20th centuries, there was a growth of the eugenics movement. Involuntary sterilization became widespread amongst people with disabilities in the hope that by doing so, it would not put pressure on the health services. Disabled men and women were institutionalized on the grounds of it being in their best interests and for the good of society. Many suffered severe emotional and physical abuse. The independent living movement was their way of fighting back in the early 1960s during a politically and socially active time. In the autumn of 1939, Adolf Hitler secretly authorized a medical program of mercy death, code-named Operation T4. It ultimately led to the deaths of an estimated 275,000 people with disabilities. In the early to mid-20th century, there was a gradual move towards integration and inclusion. The workhouses in Ireland closed by 1922 and some of the properties are still used by the house today, e.g. the Porchemna Workhouse, and the front part of the workhouse at Naas Hospital was preserved and is attached to the new hospital. After the heroes of the First World War returned with nearly 2 million newly disabled people, attitudes began to change. There was a move from institutionalization to community care. Lack of access services prolonged the charity discourse and meant that disabled people were continually viewed as objects of pity and dependent on the state. It is thought that 80% of our services were funded by non-state bodies. The church was in the driving seat, which allowed the state to relinquish their responsibility and adopt a out-of-sight, out-of-mind mentality. This was very similar to the approach taken with the mother and baby homes. The publication of the Ferns Report, 2005, McCoy Report, 2007, Murphy Report, 2009, and the Ryan Report highlight the widespread abuse of vulnerable people placed in the care of the Catholic Church in Ireland in the 20th century. In the 1960s, the idea of special educational needs was widely used based on a philosophy of segregation. Special schools were established for those with disabilities and they were educated separately from their peers in Ireland. This changed after the 1998 Education Act, which made provisions for SNAs and other supports in mainstream schools. In the 1980s, there was a worldwide call for the integration of special needs children into mainstream schools. This led to the provision of training for teachers on how to educate and interact with these children. In the mid-20th century, there were advancements in treatments such as rehabilitation, education, and drug therapies. Many institutions closed, which led to patients being moved into the communities with inadequate supports, and they were ill-prepared for life in society. The rates of homelessness rose as a direct result of discharge from institutions. The independent living movement was founded in the 1970s and its aim was to provide disabled people with rights, not charity. This is achieved through the use of personal assistance services which give disabled people autonomy and control over their own lives.